spark. What's up, Money Geeks? Mr. V here. Welcome to another video, guys. So in today's video, we are going to take a look at Desktop Metal, which is a 3D printing company that plans on going public through a reverse merger with a blank check company called Trine. So back in August, they had announced that merger. And so right now they're in the process of working out the details, and they've actually filed the SEC, the merger with SEC. So we're going to take a look at Desktop Metal and just look at their business, look at the solutions that they're providing, look at their finances and see if this if it's an interesting one to buy or to kind of wait. But before we get started, guys, if you're new to the channel, we'll talk about how to earn money, how to save money, how to invest and build wealth. So if that's something that interests you, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. So again, this year has been the year of IPOs, the year of SPARCs, reverse mergers. It looks like a lot of companies have actually figured out a loophole to go public without the nuances of pricing your IPO and all that good stuff. So this is again another example of that. You're talking about companies like Nikola Motors, which, I mean, they're going through some really trouble right now. But again, Desktop Metal is going through that same process. So let's jump on the computer, take a look at the company, look at what they do, look at their finances and see. I mean, maybe this is maybe a buy, and then see after the merger where this goes. Let's jump right in. So here we go, guys. So Desktop Metal, as you can see, it's a 3D metal printing company. Again, the evolution of 3D has actually gone from being able to print things with plastic, some sort of synthetic plastic, and now being able to print actual metal. I've actually seen there's another video that I watch on YouTube where people with 3D printing a house, which is crazy. But I don't think that is to the point where it can be commercialized. But anyway, so Desktop Metal does print 3D stuff, you know, 3D metals, and I mean, the name says it all. And so again, if you look at it, this is an industry or a space where more and more people can leverage it. So we're just gonna go through it, look at some of their solutions, some of their printers, and then look at their finances. So again, let's look at some of the products right now. So if you can look through the lines of their products, they offer printers that do print, you know, maybe some composite, they print metal, and from just a small studio standpoint where you can do it from the comfort of your basement, to maybe a shop, or maybe you own a little shop in your neighborhood, or maybe at a production system where you own a manufacturing or factory where you can actually be able to 3D print stuff. So that's a huge inventory of printers that they have there. So and again, they do cater to a lot of industries. We're going to take a look at their investor presentation here. But here's one of the things that actually got me. I got excited. So being able to print consumer goods. Can you imagine being able to print your own golf clubs? You just take a look at maybe some Calloways, and then you decide like, hey, I'm just going to print the exact same Calloway and save myself a ton of money. Hey, and that's something that I came to mind, because I love playing golf. So when I saw that, I was like, this is interesting. Look, you can 3D print your own putter, which is awesome. But let's get into the fun stuff, which is the actual, you know, SEC presentation. So again, this is Desktop Metal looking to go public with, you know, through a merger with Trine. So this is a huge deal, because just right out of the gate, they are valuing, you know, the acquisition is looking at the Desktop Metal at about, the valuation is about $2 billion, or over $2 billion, which is crazy. So again, if you look at the details of the transaction here, how everything is structured, the valuation again is about over two billion dollars. We didn't go through it, look at it, and just see what's in there. Trine overview, I don't really care so much about Trine, because I mean, basically it's just a blank check company. All they want is they want to get to Desktop Metal. So let's look at what Desktop Metal is. So you see this stuff about additive 2.0 companies. So this is just another name for 3D printing. So additive. I mean, people know how to come up with good marketing names. Additive 2.0. So Desktop Metal is the only pure play additive 2.0 public opportunity that's coming from Trine. So let's look at it. So additive market estimate to grow from 11x to 146 billion this decade. So we're talking from now to about 2030. That is a lot. So some of the key things that look like they have experience across 60 plus transactions. And then, I mean, obviously talking about their, you know, people that work for them, the scientists and all that stuff, that's good. But here's what really stands out. Again, one of the things that stands out, the fact that the fastest 3D printing platform, up to 100 times the speed of legacy technology. That is crazy. Up to 100 times. That, I mean, like, when I hear stuff like that, it gets me excited. So I kind of like to see this. And then obviously 60 plus countries, which is again, there's tremendous amount of opportunities, because there's a lot of countries out there that might benefit from this, especially to me, the third world country, where they buy cars and everything from, you know, from developed countries. And then when some of those cars break, you have to import the parts from wherever you bought that car. So that is a tremendous space for you to leverage something like this, like Desktop Metal, and be able to 3D print those parts right on the ground. So there's a lot of market there, in my opinion, in the developing countries. So again, this is how they're looking at these numbers. So the white space here, this white on the chart, the white is current, and then the red is future projected. So they're looking at, hey, from 2020 to 2030, they want to go from $12 billion to about $146 billion. That is insane. That's projected growth, but that's some growth, in my opinion. So so again, look at how the market is currently structured today, kind of the breakdown of the market. So let's see some of the key important aspects in this presentation that we can see. So again, this is some of the use cases where people can actually leverage Desktop Metal. And this is your management team, and these are, you know, board of directors. Okay, here are their product line. So product line, again, starts from the fiber, which can print composite, their studio system, which can print metal, their shop system can print metal, and their production system can print metal. So look at the difference between here. So scheduled to ship as far as volume, Q4 2020. So this should be going out here pretty soon. This fiber one. So this first one here should be going out pretty soon. And then shipping in volume since Q4 2018. This is the studio system. And then scheduled to ship in volume Q4 2020. That's the shop system. And then the production system scheduled to ship in volume the second half of 2021. So this one is still in the making. So again, that's a tremendous amount of opportunity for this company to actually grow. I'm not gonna go through all this again. I talk about how it's like 10x faster than any other system that's out there. Just gonna go through the presentation material, their software enable additive manufacturing. So basically, the way this thing is designed, you buy the printer, and you can actually, they provide, it comes with the software, you install it, you can actually design your own things and directly print it. And so they are actually comparing themselves with, you know, current or traditional manufacturing, which is good. That's why they exist in business. So if you look at traditional manufacturing and what this additive manufacturing does for you in terms of, just say, in terms of waste production, look at it, they have near zero waste. because they're not going through the process of prototyping like we do with traditional manufacturing. If you understand traditional manufacturing, you create the several prototypes before you can actually go as far as creating the real product. It would probably take 3 or 4 iterations before you get the real product. But here, you prototype on a computer. And you can just directly 3D print it, which is awesome. And then parts, they have limited geometries, and then limited geometric as far as the traditional manufacturing. Compared to desktop metal, you can pretty much anything. You can print anything that you want. As far as you can design it, you can print it. The supply chain, this I think to me, this is the one that is really, really good because it brings into play the whole concept of on demand as far as parts. Because if you own a manufacturing, let's say business, you have to print all these parts and hold that inventory and wait for people to order it. But if you own something like this, when somebody buys, you pretty much take the order, print the stuff, and ship it out. It's just like the onset of if you look at t-shirt business today, where they have direct to garment printers, where people used to print shit and just pack them in the warehouse and then sell them when somebody buys. Today, people go online and upload their logo and then they print the shirt and ship it to them. So you don't have to sit on any inventory, which is good. So I really, really like that. The energy consumption, I don't know how I can really justify this, but I think if you're using one machine to print as opposed to the traditional manufacturing where you can do casting, do several iterations, I'm pretty sure you're gonna use more energy than just a simple machine that does one sort of printing. So that's something to look at. Then look at right now, they're leading the global distribution network. Again, like I said, if you look at Africa right there, they're barely touching it. And there's a lot of market in Africa here, in my opinion, developing countries, there's a lot of market there that they can definitely get in. So again, just some of the different industries that they cater to, from transportation to consumer goods to our healthcare, name it, they are pretty much everywhere. You can, all these industries would need replacement parts and stuff like that that these guys will cater for. So just look at some of the companies that they work with, some of their customers. This is insane. Look at this customer list right here. Top companies that tells me these guys are onto something. So I'm starting to get super excited about this. Because when I initially did the research, it was good, but now that I'm actually like recording this video, it's just like I'm getting more and more excited. So just gonna scroll down here and see. Let's go down to the numbers. That's a part where I'm really interested in. So let's see right here. So detailed transaction overview. This is just basically talking more about the valuation and stuff like that. Let's see numbers for desktop metal. So this is a summary of their finances, which I think is something that we should really talk about. So revenue has increased. If you see the revenue increase and the plan on increasing that revenue, so from 26.6 and then 2015 to 25, I don't know, maybe this is because of COVID. And then 2021, it goes to 77, 2022 to 160 million, and it just keeps going up all the way to 2025. Projected earnings, revenue would be $941.5 million. Again, this company seems to be a company that is scheduled to be very profitable. In my opinion, it looks like from a cash flow perspective, they're not struggling. From the expenses, they're not struggling at all. The operating income slash the loss, to me, they are still in the phase of being able to increase their research and development. They have products that haven't even gone out yet. So you can imagine that they're gonna be spending a ton of money on those. So to me, that is just until when they conclude and have all their different products slated to be shipped and ready to go, you're gonna see that the operating income is probably still gonna be relatively higher. So all in all, this company based on what I see here and you know, and based the simple test, guys, this is the one thing. We can look at these numbers all we want. One of the key things to me that I always say, as far as when you go looking at these companies to see if this is something that you want to invest in, the first thing is, are they solving a problem, right? You should look at it, are they solving a problem? There's a huge demand for this. So I look at the problem they're solving, and I see how they're solving the solution they're providing, which is huge, right? So if you see that there's a need for this, right now, the company might not be super profitable, but they stand a chance of becoming highly profitable in the future. So to me, that's the way I see it. And so let's just kind of pause a little bit when we look at numbers, because it's always like, but they're losing money. I understand, because they're still in the developing phase, just trying to grow the company and actually get this thing up and running. So that is Desktop Metal for you. So one of the things I wanted to look at too is their SEC filing, is the closing date. When is this thing supposed to be done? So like I said earlier, it's actually scheduled to be concluded by the end of the year. So somewhere between, I think it says here, between December 31st, 2020. So that's when this thing is supposed, so fourth quarter, that's when it's supposed to be concluded. So, so right here, the business combination is not completed by December 31st, 2020, subject to automatic extension to January 31st, 2021. So that is the range in which this is gonna happen. So I think they are gonna make it work. I don't see anything that's holding them back. The filing, as far as with the SEC, unless they have some issues or there's a pushback or board of directors vote otherwise, this should actually go through. So let's look at TRNE right now. In the market, TRNE is currently trading at about, let's see, what do we have here? So TRNE is somewhere at about between, it is just alternating between $10 and $11. So the question is, right now trading at $10.90. So the question is this thing gonna hold? You know, what's gonna be the price as soon as the merger goes through? So is it a buy right now, or is it a wait and see? I think there's a high potential for this company. I think going in right now and picking up some shares here would be an excellent idea. So as you can see, guys, I think Desktop Metal has a potential of really exploding and leading this space. Since right now, if they're the number one guys leading the space, obviously they're gonna have competition, but before any other person comes in this space, they would have really created a gap between themselves and any other person. Other companies are gonna be chasing. It's like companies chasing Tesla. They wanna be the new Tesla. That's the exact same thing that's gonna happen in this space for companies wanting to be the new Desktop Metal. I mean, they've already set the groundwork, they've already set the pace. And so I think this, to me, I'm gonna buy and hold some of the TRNE stocks right now and see what happens after the merger. And if, even after the merger, I'm still gonna hang on to them, because I think this company has a huge amount of potential. Again, you're looking at the things like, hey, what problems is this company solving? Are they the leader in their space? They are solving a problem of maybe manufacturing on demand, cutting back on waste and stuff like that. And they are the number one leader in this space. So I think there's a huge upside to this stock. So I'm definitely, to me, this is a buy. But again, do your own analysis, do your own research before you jump in there, because I'm not a greedy savage, and I don't expect you to be a greedy savage as well. So let me know in the comment section, what do you think about Desktop Metal? Do you think this is really a game changer in the space of 3D printing, or it's like, hey, Mr. V, it's just another printer? Let me know in the comment section. If you're new to the channel, we'll talk about how to earn money, how to save money, how to invest and build wealth. So if that's something that interests you, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and your notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. And also, if you're looking to get started with investing, Webull is currently doing a promotion where if you deposit $100, you get two free stocks for just opening your account and depositing $100, two, not one, value somewhere between $8 and $1,600. So I'm gonna put the links in the description below. Definitely go check them out. And as always, guys, don't be a greedy savage and stay motivated.